guys, welcome back to my channel, and for those of you who might be new here, welcome. Today, I'm going to be taking you through one of the most essential tools for any housing designer in Final Fantasy XIV, and that is your subcommands and keybinds. This is a little bit different from my typical videos in that this isn't necessarily a glitch on its own, but this is how you get pretty much all of the other glitches to work. First things first, let's go over what subcommands and keybinds are. Subcommands you may not have run into too much in general in Final Fantasy XIV because they don't play a major role most of the time. Essentially what they are is a way to force the game to do things that it wouldn't normally do. Keybinds, on the other hand, you probably have run into a little bit more in Final Fantasy XIV. For example, I've seen players that set the tab key to help them target the next enemy on the list instead of having to click on each enemy. You may have attached a weapon skill to a special button on your mouse, things like that. The first thing that you'll want to check before you can start working with subcommands and keybinds is what your keybinds are. So to do that, let's open up your keybind menu and have a look. You can do this by going to your system menu, then clicking on keybind. There's obviously a lot in here that you can customize and play around with, but for what we're doing today, you'll want to go right to the system tab. Here you'll find the three essential keybinds that you need for housing design. Display subcommands, confirm, and close UI component / open system menu. By default, these keybinds will be the asterisk on your numpad, zero on your numpad, and escape in that order. The only time these will be different is if you've gone in and changed them at any point. But if you're not sure whether you've changed them, you can always come into this menu to make sure that you know what they are. Now, let me show you quickly what these keybinds should look like when they're working. First, let's try placing this window on a stage panel. As you can see, when I pull the window from my storage, it stays purple, which means that I can't just place it. So what I'll do here is hold my window where I want it, hit the asterisk on my numpad to open the window's subcommand menu. Then I'll hit zero on my numpad, which basically just tells the game that I want to use keybinds instead of the mouse. Then I'll hit zero again to actually select place. Now I'll show you quickly what the close UI component keybind does. So let's say I want to float this sofa. Normally I'd use a wooden loft to try and lift it up. If I just place the loft on the wall, nothing happens. But if I place the loft on the wall and then hit escape right away, the sofa jumps up with the loft. Then you can just go back into your housing menu and rinse and repeat until it's at the height you want. All right, well that's it for today's video. I hope that helps you with the basics of subcommands and keybinds in Final Fantasy XIV housing design. Be sure to check out my channel for other videos and detailed guides on how to use glitches to build designer homes, as well as tours of the homes that I've built. See you next time, and happy building!